Twitter world in meltdown as we speak.
Going nuts, Chief. Sorry, Duke. Absolute. The love's coming for the Force. Thick and fast. Someone suggested he looks like a stick of fairy floss with his pink shirt, but the rest of it is loving it. Someone wants to get a new hashtag going, grab a wench, which is not what Foss was talking about. He was talking about the program dancers.
Program dancers.
And so this man here said the funniest thing he's ever heard, especially about the Chief, Scott Weekly. Thanks for that. Another one said, Cameron White says the Duke doesn't have control of the commentary box.
Very good point, Cameron makes.
So anyway, they're loving the old Forsler back, and an insight into how he used to roll as a sort of a late night worker.
Gary's here, Damien Barrett is here, the Chief, Mark Howard, the boundary shortly, and James Brasher after 7 o'clock. And I've got another tweet for the great man Sam Newman, a regular tweeter to Friday Night Footy. Amy says, saw the fossil Sam Newman order lunch in Middle Park.
That's it.
Then proceed to sit in his convertible Mustang for 25 minutes and eat.
That's right.
He emerged only when a bird shat on his car. Does the fossil have an issue with tables, given there were tables available?
Well, judging by young Amy's perception into detail, it would be people like Amy that had come up and pestered the living suitcase out of you while you were sitting at a table.
There are a lot of people watching you, Sam. They thought that was unusual behaviour.
Really?
Amy's saying.
Went in and did buy some victuals, moved across, and a bird did park, made the fatal mistake of parking the car under a tree, and, of course, birds evacuated their bowels regularly on top of my car, which is not good for the Duco, and it's not, Chief. And I did eat. I don't know why I'm explaining this. I did eat. Did eat my lunch in the car, listening maybe to Triple M on the radio or Golden Oldies or whatever. And then I just drove away. I'm sorry. I'm glad Amy. She's got to get a life, Amy. Christ, if that's all that's worrying her.
As Styx just gets himself settled in with the headset, email also, just the love for the Foss tonight. I don't have a Twitter account. This is from Wazza Bailey. So I have to resort to email. I wanted to tell you how fabulous it is to have the old team back together on Triple M Footy. Hilarious. No better radio in the world than having the Foss back. And he goes on to tell a story about he used to listen when Dougie Hawkins and the Chief were on, and they're talking about footballers who are staying in hotels the night before a game to abstain. Before a game.
Obstain.
Yep. That'd be that? Doug. Yeah, yep. I asked Doug that word.
Hello. How are you, Stephen? Sam responded. We'll get to Stephen.
Oh, no,
Sam
I'm just responded acknowledging with, him. Well, we're on air, you know? Luke said to my right is the Chief. I can say there's Stephen because apparently everyone can see us, even though we're on radio.
We're going to talk to him in 5 seconds.
Well, I was ignoring. Well, he said hello. They're going to ignore him.
Can I finish my email?
I'm sorry, Gary.
He says, when asked what that meant to the wives and girlfriends who were at home by themselves, Sam responded with, well, we'll just go around there and go through them all slowly and meticulously one by one.
And if you're not up with Twitter, you can do exactly what that man did. Is email triplemfooty.com.au is the email address. And a great pleasure to welcome the man that Sam has already said hello to. He's a legend of the Carlton Football Club, of course, Fossil. The great Sam Newman and Stephen Kernan I'm talking about, who I saw this morning on the hot breakfast. You looked a little more relaxed, Sticks, this morning, and just the game face is on a touch. Welcome to Triple M Footy, Sticks.
Hello, boys. Yeah, no, I've got my speech out of the way. That's the biggest problem I have those nights. So I get that out of the way, and then I'll settle down a bit. But, yeah, good to be here, and can't wait for the siren to go and sit and watch it.
What
a great game.
What'd you go with tonight, Sticks? Would have been a full house.
Gaz, it was a riveting riveting expose of stuff. I forgot my lines. I just babbled on for about 5 minutes and get off. A quick speech is a good speech. So I've got to work on that stuff.
Yeah, no, there's got to be a start to a speech and an ending and as little possible time in between those two occurrences.
I've got to concentrate on that, Sam. I like that.
Yes.
Sticks, we've had unprecedented traffic to our website tonight. A lot of people very keen to see the outfit that Sam Newman's wearing. It's a pinkish shirt. He caught the tram
fuchsia.
In tonight.
What is it, Sam?
Fuchsia colour.
Fuchsia, is that what it is?
What I'd like you to do is spell the word fuchsia.
F-U-S-C-H-I-A? No.
I believe that's the Chief.
F-U-C-H-S-I-A.
Sticks, you're a great listener of the...
You're a good stab at it, mate, because it's pronounced how you would say that four-letter word.
Samuel, the big Sticks, he loves the Triple M. He loves the dynamic and the chemistry between current Triple M people and X. And Sticks, I know we've only got half a minute, but I think you better listen tomorrow at 12, my friend.
Well, listen, I can only assume Spud's on tomorrow, is he?
He's always
listening to him because I know he's probably coming fired up. Are you alluding me to the fact that the Spud may have something to deliver tomorrow?
He's wound he up does. Like well, a top like I've never seen him.
I could come to a few topics that I might know it's about, so I'll tell you what, I'll be tuned in tomorrow to listen to the great man go off.
Do exactly that, Sticks. It's going to be explosive at 12 o'clock tomorrow. We've got to let him go because you've got a massive night tonight. The Carlton president, Stephen Kernan.
Thanks, Sticks.
Thanks, guys.
Great friend of Gentleman Footy. Thank you to the great man, Sticks Kernan.